Hey, brothers and sisters, let's worship the Lord. Let's worship Him. He reigns forevermore. Hallelujah. World Revival Church, St. Louis, Missouri. Hallelujah. He reigns. Hallelujah. Worship Him. Praise Him. Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of His people. Hallelujah.
Jesus is the Lord.
Praise Him.
Jesus is the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He reigns.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. There's none like You, Lord. Hallelujah.
There is no one who is like
You. No one is like You, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah, Jesus. To see You as You are. Open the eyes of our heart, Lord. Hallelujah. Your people see You, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Jesus is the Lord. Forevermore.
Hallelujah. I just release the anointing that the Lord gave me. I release it in the church. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
He reigns.
Hallelujah. Does He reign over you? Does Jesus reign over you?
Jesus is the Lord. Reigns forevermore.
Glory to His name. Hallelujah.
Jesus is the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He reigns.
Hallelujah. He reigns. Hallelujah. Does He reign in your heart tonight? Hallelujah. Is Jesus reigning over your heart? Or is fear and doubt reigning over your heart? Is the world reigning over your heart? Is the things of this world ruling over your heart? Pornography, alcohol, drugs, worry. You know, causing hate and discontent on YouTube, causing hate and discontent in your family, causing hate and discontent in your church. What rules and reigns over your heart? A desire to be the center of attention, a desire to be seen and get negative attention. Or what is it that rules and reigns in your heart tonight? That's what I asked you. I asked you, is Jesus the Lord of your life tonight? It's not just a cliche. It's not just words. It's not just a sinner's prayer. But it's the Bible says it's to be a doer of the word in James chapter 1. I believe it's about verse 22, to be a doer of the word. Hallelujah.
He reigns.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, my friends, the day is coming when Jesus will return, and the Bible says He'll rule this earth with a rod of iron. So right now, Jesus' kingdom is within us, He said. He rules and reigns to the hearts of His people. The Spirit of God reigns in the hearts of His people. By choice, we have a free will choice to answer the call of God. Jesus said, you know, you didn't choose me, I chose you. And He called us. And then we answer Him and follow Him daily. Hallelujah. So He's our Lord, brothers and sisters. But you know, the day is coming. For those of you who are watching this video, Jesus said in His word, the Bible says in the New Testament, every knee shall bow of things in heaven. That's even the angels. Every tongue shall confess. Let me back that up. Let me try to say the whole verse correctly. That every knee shall bow of things in heaven. That's even the holy angels. Things on the earth, that's all peoples, nations and tongues, and all on this earth and under the earth. Meaning even Satan himself shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Even Satan will bow and confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. All the people in hell will bow and say Jesus Christ is Lord, for He will literally rule and reign in all places, even in the natural, even on this world. He will rule with the rod of iron. When He returns at the end of the tribulation, So that's what I'm telling you now by the Spirit of God. Do it today. Do it today while it's a free will. Do it today. And let the Bible verse be fulfilled in your life where God says in Jeremiah, draw close to me and I'll draw close to you. Call upon me and I'll answer you and I'll show you great and mighty things that you know not. That it may be fulfilled in you. Where Jesus said, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever should believe in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Let the word of God be fulfilled in you. That says, and Jesus said in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. Let's worship the Lord. Let's worship him. Let's praise his holy name. He reigns. He reigns. He reigns forevermore. Let's worship the Lord for a minute. I want to worship him.
I just want you more, more. I just want you.
Do you want the Lord more? It's not even... Let me pause it. You know, the Lord put me on here to preach. I'm going to back it up. Listen, brothers and sisters, this is World Harvest Revival Church. You can find this on the internet, on YouTube for free. It's not even about the rapture. You know, lots of people, you know, we, and even myself, of course we want to be raptured. Let me tell you something. It's not about being raptured. I want to be with the one who raptures me. It's not about being healed. I want to be with the healer. It's not about being saved. I want to be with the Savior. You know, stop looking at Jesus' hands and seek his face. For God said in his word, 2 Chronicles 7:14, speaking by the Spirit through King Solomon at the dedication of the temple in Jerusalem. And God spoke by the Spirit, his Holy Spirit through King Solomon said, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, let's repent, and seek my face. Seek my face. Thy face I shall seek. That's another Bible verse. Thy face shall I seek. And that's a whole other message, brothers and sisters, but I'm just always do as I'm doing in this video, speaking by the Spirit of God, bubbling up as that river of living water in my belly, and tell you, stop seeking his hands. Of course, God wants to heal you. God wants to deliver you. But Jesus said, if your right eye offends you, pluck it out and cast it in the sea. For it's better to enter heaven with one good eye than hell fire with two good eyes. So healing is awesome in the natural. But I don't want to be healed as much as I want the healer. I don't want to be redeemed as much as I want the redeemer. I don't want to be raptured as much as I want to be with the one who raptures. So I don't want to be saved as much as I want to be with the Savior. I mean, I want to be with Jesus. I just want you more. Let's worship him for a minute, brothers and sisters. Let the anointing of the living God, the Holy Spirit, overtake you. Let's let the Holy Spirit overtake us right now. Sing it to him. Sing it to him. Tell him you want him more. Hallelujah, Lord. We want you more, Lord. Oh, Lord, I just want you more. Oh, just want you. Hallelujah. Tell him, I want you, Lord. I seek your face. Hallelujah. I want to get a hold of you, Lord. Personal relationship with you. I want to walk with you in the garden in the cool of the day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come meet us, Lord. Come and meet us, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen, brothers and sisters. You know, you can find these songs and listen to them. Listen, brothers and sisters. I want to tell you this. God is moving mightily in His people. The days of this earth are growing strangely dim as we enter into the time for the tribulation period to begin, brothers and sisters, and for our departure out of this world as the midnight hour is coming. As I talk about many times, as the Lord has led me, we are into that twilight zone. We're in the twilight of the day of the church. Brothers and sisters, we are in the last moments of the church age, brothers and sisters. Just worship the Lord. You got to get a hold of the hem of His garment. You got to get a hold of Jesus. You got to want more of Jesus. You got to want to get a hold of the Savior. Face time with Jesus. How do you know somebody if you don't spend time with them? And I don't mean a one-way conversation, a petitioning prayer all the time. Be still. Be still and know that I am Lord, the Bible says. That's the message that the Lord wants me to give you today. Be still and know that He is the Lord. Listen, brothers and sisters, I need to go. I always say I want to cut my videos short so that, you know, the more people would watch them, because I want the message that the Lord gave me to get out. You know that I love you guys. I will be going to Merle's Inlet. I wasn't sure about going down. The Lord keeps pressing me to go. Some things happened today that, you know, was a confirmation that I really need to go down there to the south of Myrtle Beach, to this near Myrtle Beach. If you're in that area, please contact me. I've got several people I'm seeing down there to pray with in different situations. Down in the Myrtle Beach area, greater Myrtle Beach area. I'll be down there this coming week. That's June 28th, 29th, along in there. I'll be down there for about 3 or 4 days visiting with brothers and sisters, praying with them. If you're in that area, please contact me. I will also be driving to Chicago. I've decided to go ahead and drive up there, brothers and sisters, so I can see people along the way. So you just have to look at a map. If you're halfway between North Carolina and Chicago, like, I don't know yet, Indianapolis maybe, I don't know all the routes, possibly get with me, and then I'll be driving, of course, over from Chicago to Minneapolis. One sister's already contacted me. She lives about halfway in between. I think it's Eau Claire, Wisconsin maybe, somewhere along in there. I will be going up there approximately July 21st through about a week. I'll be up in that area, Chicago and Minneapolis, brothers and sisters, the last week of July. So God bless you, brothers and sisters. I'll just say now, July 24th, for sure, I'm open that day to see anybody that wants to see me, and I will be in Napierville, suburb of Chicago, on July 24th, for sure, that day. Probably other days too, I'm not sure, but I've already got some schedules. But the 24th, which is a Friday of July, is open in Chicago area, Napierville, a suburb of Chicago. So anyone in that area that hasn't contacted me, please contact me. I already have a full schedule for 2 other days to see people baptized in water, pray for baptism of the Holy Spirit, pray for words of wisdom, words of knowledge, to be healed, healings. You know, I usually don't talk about too much, but the Lord has given me a healing ministry too. And I pray with lots of people by the grace of God who have been healed over the years I've been in the ministry, by the hundreds when I do crusades in the Philippines. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. It's all just by faith and His mighty power, by His Spirit. And, you know, God can use you in those areas too. It's just a matter of just having the faith and the fortitude to press forward to do it, brothers and sisters. Trusting God. Faith meaning just simply childlike trust in the Lord's and His power and His will to be done in all things. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'll be up in those areas. And when I leave, I need to make a separate video, but I'll just say it now tentatively. What I'm going to do, by the grace of God, this is the wisdom that the Lord gave me. I will drive. I can see some people, limited people, on the way to Chicago. I can add a day and stay an extra day along the way somewhere if there's, you know, the Lord tells me to, or there's enough people. It would be logical. So I don't, you know, as it comes together. But I need to be in Chicago by July 22nd, the night of July 22nd. I have scheduled the 22nd, 23rd, and I'm open for the 24th to see people for all those ministry needs, 24th, in the greater Chicago area. Then I will go for the weekend Sunday. I think that's the 26th of July. be traveling on Saturday. Can see people Saturday night in Minneapolis and Sunday. Be baptizing people. White Bear Lake in the greater Minneapolis area on Sunday, July 26. And I can also baptize people Saturday night when I get there in time. Maybe we'll stay at a place that's got a pool. If it's open late, you know, we can do it there. Also, you don't have to, if you can't make it Sunday, to the lake. Anyway, brothers and sisters, by the grace of God, when I come back from Minneapolis, I'll try to take an alternative route back this way, brothers and sisters, so that I can get some other places. I have to look at a map and see how all that works. I don't know. Please contact me. If you look at a map, you can see what's the logical way. I can kind of make a loop around. Through some, you know, I don't know necessarily St. Louis is on the way. It's up to the Lord. It's a, you know, it's a big area, and of course, every area needs revival. God bless you, brothers and sisters. This is the plan that the Lord has gave me. Like I said, the immediate short term, southeastern coast of South Carolina, you know, the eastern coast of South Carolina and southern North Carolina. If you're in that area, please contact me. I've already got several people, but, I can make room. I still have an open day that I'll leave open down there for anybody else. So I'll be down there this coming Sunday night. I'll be down there and through maybe Wednesday. And Lord willing, if he wants me to stay longer and schedule comes together, I can stay longer. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you all. I love you all. May the Lord be a spirit be upon you. I want to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, hallelujah. I just speak right now, hallelujah. I just hear in the spirit joy unspeakable and full of glory. That's the Bible verse that's coming in my spirit. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. It's what I'm hearing in the spirit from the Most High God. Brothers and sisters, I ask for your prayers, that all things will come together for the ministry travels that I do right now for the Lord. I ask you for continued prayers for Joshua's ministry, for the four orphanages and 1,000 kids. By the grace of God, street kids were able to feed every week. Poor indigenous children. Squatter area, their parents live, they just squat on government land and whatnot in shacks. You know, we teach them and feed them 1,000 a week. Ask for your prayers for that God would continue to expand. I mean, the pastors doing the feedings want to expand more and more and more, of course. There's always new areas, unreached areas. And just all that we can do, we want to do. We want to run the race and get everything done and more orphanages and collect more orphans across the Philippines. Who that God would send to us that we can. So I ask you to pray that we'll get new orphans, more orphans. We need more orphans to fill up these four orphanages and then open more in other parts of the Philippines by the grace of God. Just unlimited. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to work while it's light. Even though it's only twilight, I'm going to work while it's daylight, as the Lord said, because nighttime's coming, no man can work. And I'm going to work, brothers and sisters, by the grace of God with your help and your prayers. I'm going to continue to press forward to the high calling of Jesus Christ in my ministry, in my life. And I pray for each one of you to do that. I'm trying to challenge you. That's why I'm on here, brothers and sisters, as an example to you. You know, you guys who have discernment, you can tell if someone is, bragging up themselves and all that kind of stuff. You guys can discern that. Those of you who are mature in the Lord. It's an example to you, brothers and sisters, to provoke you. To be all you can be for Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters. Be all you can be for Jesus Christ. Serve Him with all of your heart. Seek His face. Deny not His calling in your life. But be filled with His glory. I'm just speaking as the Lord is leading me. For those of you who are tone deaf in the Lord, I pray for you not to be tone deaf. But he who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord says to the church. But not only that, I take it to a new level. And not only say that, you know, to have an ear to hear, but that God would give you an ear. If you don't have an ear, God would give you an ear to hear. May God bless you with the ability to hear His voice, because Jesus said, my sheep know my voice, and they answer not to another. May the Lord fill you with the wisdom to hear His voice, that you would do His will in your life today. Not hesitate and delay any longer, but move out in faith. That God would fulfill and fill you. You know, just like when they had the 5 loaves of bread and the fish. You know, it didn't get multiplied till Jesus prayed over it and broke bread. And it was multiplied as they gave it out. It wasn't multiplied in advance the day before or an hour before. It was multiplied when they moved out, when the disciples moved out with the food. It multiplied as they gave it out. It just kept, the basket just stayed full. You see what I'm saying? When the servants at the wedding in Cana, John chapter 2, they poured the water, it turned to wine. When all the other wine was gone and they needed it, Jesus said, fill the pitchers with water. It was water. And then as the servant began to pour it, it turned to wine as he was giving it. While it was still in the jugs, oh, it's just water. And then it says, as he poured it, it turned to wine. So God gives us provision on time. We don't wait for the provision to move out. We move out and then, we step on the water and then the water, by faith, we're able to walk on the water. But you got to step on the water first, brothers and sisters. God wants us to step out by faith. And that's what I'm trying to tell you. And I'm giving you some information, testimony about what I've done for the Lord so that you would be provoked and encouraged that the Lord is waiting for you to step out. Step out by faith. God bless you, brothers and sisters. I will see all of you guys by the grace of God. And we have a good time in the Lord and accomplish all that God wants us to do in fellowship. God bless.